Two Mongrel Mob gang members are working with a social housing provider to change the lives of prisoners once they're on the outside. They say those released don't have the necessary services they need to be reintegrated back into society. And as Sam Kelway reports, the program needs funding.
Former AOS police officer Damien White has seen Carl Goldsberry at his worst.
Looking down the barrel of a rifle, out comes Mr. Goldsberry's.
It was a different sort of a life, just all over the place really. Just fried, needed meth to operate really.
Behind bars for a decade, he's familiar with being on the wrong side of the law. Now, 2 years out of prison, he's turning things around with the support of people like Damien White.
I just wanted to start being a better father, a husband. I knew my roles in it because I learned what a good father looked like.
The patched Mongrel Mob members are working for Tutuinga Whānau Services, an organisation that's helped hundreds of vulnerable families and now plans to support gang members nearing the end of their sentence.
It'll work because, you know, just like we want Māori to look after by Māori for Māori in the housing, homeless sector.
Those influential people that are in the community, in the Mongrel Mob, their influence could influence 10, 20 families.
Freedom for Whānau will target influential members of any gang, only if they're willing to change, and they won't rip them away from the patch.
You can't take someone away from what they've always known all their life. It'd be like someone taking you off your parents, because at the end of the day, one of our bros is not going to listen to someone else.
Freedom for Whānau would start with 5 homes. In each house, one recently released prisoner and their family. While there, they'd be provided with wraparound services, and after 12 weeks would look to transition into their own home. They've already been into prisons to talk about the kaupapa, and in the Bay of Plenty, the collaboration between gang members and police is seeing huge results.
All it takes now is a phone call to have some tension lessened, I guess, and it is a true partnership. Aspirationally, these guys want the same as what we want for our families.
These men are asking the government to give them another chance.
Certainly it's something that we can look at further as to basically engage more with them and talk about how our priorities as a government and corrections priorities align with the skills and the knowledge that they bring.
I've got a good job, all because Tommy gave me a chance. I've got my place back at home, all because my wife Jess gave me a chance. Right down to the police. The police gave me a chance, and here I am, thriving.
Using their experience behind bars to help others head in a new direction. Sam Calloway, One News.